Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Southern Raised Biscuits, and this is my favorite recipe for Southern Raised Biscuits. I've made biscuits for you before, I've made rolls for you before. This is a cross between biscuits and rolls. You need yeast in order for it to rise, but it will still have a biscuit taste. And I decided to make it now because it's getting close to Easter and you might be able to use it on your Easter table. Or you might want it for Easter breakfast. But it's not something that you have to save for a special occasion. You can use it anytime and enjoy it. So I hope you really like these Southern Raised Biscuits. And we start with our yeast. I have two packages of active dry yeast. And I've cut off the corners, so I'll be able to put it in water. This is 1/4 cup of water that I got from the faucet, and I have my thermometer in here because I want to make sure it was lukewarm, which translates to about 105 degrees. So somewhere around there will be fine. And then just pour this in. Remember, you need two of them. And these are just standard size packets, 0.75 ounces. And try to get everything in because it will kind of go to the corners and stick a little bit. And then stir that up. And this is going to be pretty thick because we're not using a whole lot of water for the yeast, but the yeast will dissolve in the water and it will get nice and bubbly. And we can't really proceed with our recipe until that happens. And that takes about 5 minutes. So in about 5 minutes, I'll be back and we'll continue with the recipe. Now here's what your mixture of yeast and water will look like. It's kind of bubbling on the top. And that's about what you want after 5 minutes. And what I'm gonna do is mix this with buttermilk. I took a container like this. This is 1 pint or 2 cups. And I got it out of the refrigerator about a half hour ago because I wanted it to warm up a little bit. Didn't want it super chilled because that might kill the yeast. So what we're going to do is take our 2 cups of buttermilk that we have sitting here, and we're going to pour in our mixture of yeast and water. Sometimes there'll be a few dregs at the bottom and you just bring those in, but it's pretty clean. Stir that around. Try to get it fairly even. And then set that aside. So I'm just going to put it over here as I continue to work. Now the next thing I have is my flour. Now I already have it in a big bowl because there's a lot of it. It's 5 cups of self-rising flour. If you don't have self-rising flour, just use all-purpose flour. Now for each cup of all-purpose flour, add 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and you'll be fine. You'll be at the same place I am. We're going to add some shortening, and I don't really like cooking with Crisco that much. This recipe should have Crisco or lard for the flakiest and finest of biscuits. But if you don't like cooking with those, use butter. That'll be fine. You need 1 cup of shortening. I happen to be using this white Crisco. So I'm going to put that out. Well, first I'm going to put some more dry ingredients in. I forgot about my sugar here. Your yeast always needs to feed off the sugar. So you have 1/3 cup of sugar, and I think I'll try to mix these dry ingredients together first before I attempt to incorporate the shortening. So we'll just get those. And that's pretty good. It will continue to be mixed as we get our shortening blended in. So our shortening, I'm just going to take a fork and get this out. And then what we're going to do is cut it in with a pastry blender. Or you could use a fork if you don't have a pastry blender. So let's get this out and set this aside and go to our pastry blender. This will take me a while, but what I want to do is come up with a mixture that resembles coarse crumbs. So I'll just keep working kind of moving around, getting more of the flour incorporated with the Crisco. And when I get it to the point I want it, then we'll go back and look at our buttermilk mixture. And those are going to go together, and pretty soon we will be making our Southern Raised Biscuits. Here we have our flour and Crisco mixture along with the sugar, and you can see what it looks like. It's kind of crumbly, but it's fairly evenly crumbled. When you get to that point, you can take out your pastry blender, try to get off any excess, and then we're going to put our buttermilk yeast mixture in. So all of it goes in. We'll just kind of spread it around a little bit. You can see what that looks like. It empties out very nicely. We're through with that. And now it's a matter of getting this together into a dough. You can use your fork. I think I probably can use something a little bit larger than that. Big ladle like this, or spatula. Just try to get the wet and dry ingredients incorporated. So we'll mix that a little bit, and then we'll be ready to put it out on the counter. After you stir your dough around a little bit, you'll probably want to work it with your hands to be able to get it really combined properly. And when it looks like this, it's a nice soft dough, you're going to bring it out onto a floured surface. Now, I use my counter all the time, and we've lived here 21 years and I've had this same countertop, and I've not damaged it yet to a significant degree, so I've continued to do that. I know some of you have special boards and things. I have a marble board, but it's just kind of too narrow for me to work with a large dough like this. But it needs to be floured. So if you have a shaker can like this, that's nice to just sprinkle it, because you can sprinkle it pretty easily and evenly. So we'll start right there, because all I'm going to do at the beginning is bring this out and knead it about 3 or 4 times. So that just means bring it over and turn it on itself, and usually make a rotation, fold it over, and just go around until you feel like you're getting it to be easy to work with. So that's about it. So I have used up the flour here, so I'm going to replenish. So I'm just going to place this down and stretch it out a little bit to give it a head start on the rolling. And we'll put it down here. We'll put some flour on the top to keep it from sticking to the rolling pin. So I've got a job here now where I need to roll this to 1/2 inch thickness. So it's going to take me a little bit, but I'll try to be as even as possible. And I just go back and forth, and then I change and go in the opposite direction for a while. I may go diagonally if I want to round it out. So you can imagine what I'm doing, but when I come back, it should be 1/2 inch thick all over. So here is the dough that I've come up with, and it looks like it's about 1/2 inch thick. Now, what I plan to do is to cut these with my 2 3/4 inch biscuit cutter, and I'll just go straight down at this spot right here. And then I want to remove that. I didn't think to get an implement, but this is coming out pretty well. And this is something that I've added in over the years. It's optional, but I kind of like them dipped in butter. I've already sprayed this baking sheet, and you kind of need a jelly roll pan or something of that type, which has a rim here. But I just dip this in very quickly and get both sides, and then place that in my pan. So I can just keep going along there till I fill it across, and just keep going with rows. And I think I have more dough here than it will take to fill that pan. So I'm going to work on this and get it ready, and I'll show you what it looks like in the pan before it goes in the oven. Here are our biscuits that are formed up in the pan, and they're already starting to rise. They're a little bit actually above the pan right there, and I think this is supposed to be an inch or so. But it made up to here, so that would be 20, And then I had to roll again the scraps, and you can see this is kind of the way it came out because I needed four extra ones, and there were some more down here. But at this point, you need to cover it loosely, in the sense that I like it to be fairly airtight, but I don't want it to stick too much, so I allow a little space for it to expand, because we expect this to double in bulk before we put it in the oven. I'm going to need another piece of plastic wrap here. So we'll just put that over the edge. And like I said, keep it loose so there is room for those biscuits to expand. And we want to let them sit in a warm place, free of drafts, and let it rise for about 2 hours. Here's what your Southern Raised Biscuits should look like after 2 hours. They have doubled in size, and you want to remove the plastic wrap. Don't leave that on. So we're gonna put these in a 450-degree oven and let them bake for about 10 to 12 minutes, and then we'll bring them out and show them to you. Here are our Southern Raised Biscuits straight from the oven. They're very hot, but this is the way they should look when they're done. They baked for 10 minutes exactly. And what I usually do is immediately I transfer them to a bowl, and I usually put a napkin or some kind of linen in the bowl so I can wrap them up a little bit and keep them warm in case I need to, because these are best when they're eaten straight from the oven, when they're really hot. See the backside of them? They look really nice, so let me get these placed in our bowl and then I'll come back to you. So here we have our Southern Raised Biscuits. I only put part of the pan in here because I chose a small bowl. Of course, you can choose a very large basket or a bowl or whatever and fit them all in. There were 24. But when I opened this, I could see steam coming out of it. So I'm just gonna pick one. This one looks good. I like the crustiness of the bottom. And put it over here on my plate. I'll keep these warm so that when Rick has one, it'll be very hot. And probably all we'll eat is one a piece, if that much. And then we'll let these cool off and we will put them in the freezer. And then if there is some special occasion that calls for 22 biscuits, then we'll have them ready to serve. But otherwise, we'll just eat on them in a snacky way, kind of maybe for breakfast occasionally, although that's truly not the kind of breakfast we have. So I want to show you a bite of one of these. I'm set up here with my Earl Grey tea. There you go. And I've got some butter and also some honey. So let's open this up, let you see the texture of it. It's really hot. And this is what you expect it to look like. And I'm going to put my butter right in the center there and close it back up and give it just a minute to work. It's okay for me for it to have a little bit of substance of butter in the middle, but the best part is the gooiness of the melted butter. So let's see what it's doing inside. It's beginning to melt. So that's good for tasting. I'll just come over here to the edge so I make sure I get a little butter on this edge. So good. I did get out my recipe card from about 35 years ago, and on my card I had written, I always write notes to myself, I had written excellent, the best, with an exclamation point. So that means my opinion of it was you couldn't do better than this. So if you're looking for a Southern Raised Biscuit, you might like this. I'm going to take one more bite here now that the butter is melted a little more, and I'm going to take some of this honey. This is just a good taste combination if you are having just a snack with your tea in the afternoon, which is where it is for us. And let's get a little of that honey. There's just enough saltiness and flavor in the biscuit to balance with that honey to make it delicious. I really love these, and I hope you will too.